Whether you're seeking to be a ballet dancer or not, ballet is an extraordinary tool that has the capacity to raise your consciousness and take you to a greater version of who you are. Through ballet, you can shape your body, but beyond that, you can shape your life. Today, we're focusing on a subject that is at the core of the Ballet and Identity program, the profound benefits that can be derived from a ballet education. And I can't think of anyone better to discuss this with than my dear friend and colleague, Zippora Karz.
Dreamt about being a ballerina. I think I just wanted to make a difference in this world. So I was always drawn to doing something, but it wasn't necessarily ballet. So my first 2 years, it was very technical. It was just learning a lot of the positions. And to me, that's why am I putting my feet in these positions? It didn't really speak to me, but it also could have been the lack of inspiration from that teacher. And so at the end of my class, I would go and stand at the other studio and watch the older girls dance and watch them with this other teacher. And something was happening in that studio that I wasn't getting the experience of. They were all in the moment, the inspiration, you could just hear it without hearing sound because I was outside the studio. So I thought, you know what? I'm gonna find out what's going on in that studio. And all I know is that whatever I was learning in that studio, the more I trained my body, the more I became a vessel and a vehicle, and all of a sudden something would happen. And I would just have these experiences of just the music flowing through me. And it was just, it wasn't just that I wasn't thinking anymore about all the things that were not working in my life or that I was unhappy about. It was actually that I was experiencing love. And I like to say that this was the first time in my life that I've understood a bigger love, not just, oh, I love my mom, I love my dad, I love my sisters. Actually, something bigger than who I was would happen to me. And I didn't know that that was something there for me to experience. I just didn't want to be home. I didn't like the way I felt about myself at home. I didn't like the way I felt at school. My friends and I were getting in fights. What I would say is that it wasn't a thought, it was an experience. I was experiencing something that I liked about myself in the ballet studio. And it wasn't just about me, it was about life. It sort of revealed to me that there's more to life and more for me to experience about my ability to connect with something in this world. And I experienced it in a ballet studio.
In a way, what you were connecting with was your identity. You were connecting in the deepest way with who you are at the highest level of who you are, even at that young age, which is part of what this whole program is about, really, is this idea that ballet really does bring you, and can do it quite quickly, to this greater feeling of yourself, of the world, that it connects you to something much greater than the everyday.
I was getting to experience who I was, as you said, on the deepest level.
Yeah, exactly.
Because it connects so many parts of ourselves.
Right.
We are being physical, we're being mental, because we have to think what we're doing. We're sculpting our body without pushing it in an exercise way.
Right.
We're actually creating some sort of pathway into an energetic realm that we're connected with.
There's no company in America like George Balanchine's New York City Ballet. It is the company. Just to be in the presence of Balanchine, and then you become one of the last three dancers that Balanchine ever chooses for his company. And in a sense, what you were seeing, I mean, all the people that he and his company and his ballets attracted, it's like he was great, and greatness attracts more greatness. So you were sort of in this web of not just talented people, but really brilliantly talented people. When you think of who was in that company at that time.
We would have Baryshnikov and Nureyev, all these, the greatest dancers of all time who were alive at that time would come and take class alongside Peter Martins and all of the people within the New York City Ballet. And, you know, you were really witnessing greatness. I believe that when each person is behaving, existing at their highest, their most, their right. fullest, their right. biggest potential, and then you put them all in the room together, I always say you just put your toe in that room and it takes you with you, with them. It's like right. you're just catapulted along with the energy. I felt like I was seeing God. I really felt I was having not a religious experience, but a spiritual awakening. I was besides myself, speechless that I was there.
See, now let's talk just for a minute about that teacher, Sheila Rosanne.
Yeah.
I know how special she still is to you, and that she called herself your spiritual mother.
Yeah.
And at a very young age, 15, you went to New York for the summer program of the School of American Ballet. And just to explain what that is, it's probably the greatest ballet school in America. It is the school of the great George Balanchine. And what an honor to get taken there.
I did love New York City. I loved the energy of the city, but it was a little bit too much. But Sheila wasn't having any of it. Sheila really felt that I belonged in New York and I belonged dancing for George Balanchine. I said, okay, I didn't understand why she was, you know, I didn't know George Balanchine at this point. So when I went back to New York at 15, they asked me if I would stay on as a winter student studying full time in the winter. And, you know, again, I still hadn't seen the New York City Ballet or George Balanchine at this point. I went home and at the end of the class with Sheila says to me, oh, how was it this summer? And I said, oh, I think they really liked me this summer. And she says, oh, why? And I said, well, because they asked me if I would stay on as a winter student. And Sheila just didn't even blink an eye. She said, you're going. And I said, what? And it was really her enthusiasm and her belief in me. I really would have never, ever thought of going to New York at 15 years old if it wasn't for Sheila. I had no expectations. I was just happy to be there. I was so happy. Now I would get to be on stage. Now, even though Balanchine had died, we got to feel his presence by dancing his ballets, and it was still his company. Right. All the people that trained with him were there. And so they took it upon themselves to sort of nurture and look over some of the younger ones. Great Suzanne Farrell would, you know, keep an eye out for me.
Suzanne Farrell was one of the great loves of Balanchine's life and certainly his muse as a ballerina for many years.
Well, Balanchine asked Suzanne to teach at the School of American Ballet my first year there. So I think she recognized something in me as a teacher. And then when I got into the company, I felt her watching out for me. She became my Balanchine. I was so inspired by her and her performances.
A lot of people feel that she really was the living embodiment of Balanchine.
Yeah. When Suzanne would dance, I would lose sense of time and space. I'd go into watching it and I'd come out and I didn't know how much time had gone by. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I didn't know where I was. She took you with her. When you said sometimes watching ballet can bring you to that place, mm-hmm. when she was dancing, I felt that I was dancing. Mm-hmm. I felt my soul with her because she had such a crazy ability to just enter into a space, a time and space lapse, like warp, a portal, and take all of us watching her with her. The biggest gift was to be able to feel that I was dancing by watching her. there was not easy. I mean, I'm in a company of the greatest athletes in the world, right, and they're all at their primes. I wanted to run. I wanted to run because it was so painful. And I realized that I'll never forgive myself if I don't give myself the chance, because I do love this so much. I do love it so much. And so that's why I stayed. Really, I needed it. I needed the stage. The stage was the place where I remembered who I was.
Right.
I didn't have diabetes when I was on that stage.
Right.
You know,
right.
I experienced the essence, the core of that identity that you're talking about, that thing that I discovered in Sheila's studio was there when I stepped on stage. I think I was finding my life on the stage. I was reconnecting with who I truly am in my essence. One of my teachers at the ballet approached me. There's something called the George Balanchine Trust, which is a trust that's set up that whenever a company around the world or a school wants to perform the works of George Balanchine, they send somebody out who is educated in the work to teach it and to coach it. And so I tried it. And the first ballet that I staged, I had that same kind of experience that I had in Sheila's studio. Mm-hmm. And it just happened to me. And the love was just flooding into me. I more feel of myself as a dancer teaching a dancer rather than, I don't feel as removed from my students. I feel like we're having a shared experience and I'm really just trying to help them become the best that they can be. And if they choose to be professionals, great. If they don't, that's okay too. They'll take dance with them and what it did for them and their heart and their lives. And I just want them to be the best person they can be and who they want to be.
I mean, this is the great thing about ballet. What you get from it is something that you take your whole life. It lives within you. Again, it's identity. I think taking ballet at any stage of your life really does give you something that you'll carry with you forever. Don't you think so?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And it's not just exercise. It's what we said before.
Exactly.
You're giving your body physical information that's just going to, you know, on the physical level, elongate it, bring breath into it. It's going to help it be nourished on so many levels. But then you're learning to inhabit your body with your heart and your soul. It's like, it's what I said before. It's like our presence emanates from our hearts.
Right.
And so I think ballet just touches there, just touches that heart.
Yeah. So if you were talking to somebody who, a young person who they know they don't want to be a dancer, but they're looking at you or they're looking at a ballet or they're listening to ballet music and they think, this could be a lot of fun or it could be really interesting. What would you tell them they can derive from a ballet education?
I feel like energetically, ballet gives you confidence to do things that maybe you wouldn't have done. It gives you spatially an experience of yourself as bigger and beautiful. The way that the combinations work with your body, you know, you have to be doing something with your arm, another thing with your leg, another thing with your head. All of these synapses that are going on with your brain actually help your intelligence. It makes you smarter. It fires up all these things inside your body that are going to help you with school, that are going to help you with emotional intelligence.
Right.
You'll be able to sort out problems in a different way because you're tapping into your brain in so many ways. I think ballet can help connect you to a really deep part of yourself, physically, emotionally, spiritually. I think it just brings the whole thing together in a really beautiful way.
Really does. Zippora, thank you so much. And now in closing, I would like to quote something that your wonderful teacher, Sheila, once said. I'm going to read it. She said, "To me, ballet is just the most wonderful thing in the world. It doesn't matter whether you're a professional or not, but just studying it, studying a formal classical art, is the best gift any parent can give their child."